So we've already learned that sound travels as a wave. And we've learned that waves have crests at the top and troughs at the bottom. The distance between two crests is called a wavelength. So here's one crest, here's the second crest, and the distance between the two is the wavelength. You can change the pitch of a note or how high or low a note is by simply changing the wavelength. I have some musical instruments here called boomwhackers. They're simply a plastic tube that's hollow. So air goes in one end, comes out the other end, and vibrations are produced inside the tube when I hit it on my hand, like so. So what's happening in this tube is we have these sound waves right inside, going up and down. I have three different sizes of boomwhackers. I have this very long one that's red, I have a shorter one that's orange, and I have an even shorter boomwhacker that's yellow. Let's experiment and see what happens to the pitch as we get shorter in size. Let's start with the longest boomwhacker. Listen carefully. When I move to the shorter orange boomwhacker, what do you think is going to happen? Do you think the sound is going to get higher? Or do you think the sound is going to go lower? Make your prediction now. Great, let's try it and see. Here's the shorter, listen carefully. What happened? I'll play them back to back just in case you missed it. Here's the longer tube. And here's the shorter tube. What did you observe? When we shortened the tube, the sound was higher, or the pitch was higher. Pitch is just another word for the tone of the sound. So if we use an even shorter boomwhacker, what do you think will happen to the pitch? Will it be higher than both of these, lower than both of these, or will it be in between the two? Make your prediction now, higher, lower, or in between. All right, let's listen one more time. Here's the longest. Here's the second longest, and here's the shortest. Did you expect it to be higher pitched? You're exactly right. When we shorten the length of the tube, the pitch gets higher. So what's happening? Well, if we look at our waves, in our longest tube, we have a very low pitch because the wavelengths are very, very long. You can see here in red how long that wavelength is. When I go to a higher tube, like the yellow tube, my pitch goes up as well, and that's because the wavelength got shorter. So you can see the lower pitch had the long wavelength, the higher pitch had the short wavelength. We simply change the pitch by changing the wavelength. A good way to remember this is that long wavelengths equal lower sounds. L for long and L for low. Long wavelengths equal lower sounds. Short wavelengths equal higher sounds. If we apply this to real instruments that we see in an orchestra, let's think about a flute versus a tuba. Tubas are big instruments and they have really long tubes. Flutes are smaller instruments that have a very short tube. If flutes have a shorter tube and tubas have a longer tube, which instrument is going to have the higher pitch? Exactly. The flute's going to have the higher pitch because it has a shorter tube. The tuba has the long tube, which means it has a lower pitch. Thank you for joining me today to learn a little bit about sound.